Ladies and gentlemen, ladies, children of all ages, and welcome to the Only Road Road Podcast. Guess who you have here? Two guys that are here every time.
I dare you to guess. Just stand in public. Is it Jason? Jason?
is it Rod?
Rick? John? It's gotta be Rick. People just looking at you like, why did you say names?
My name is John.
Yeah.
His name is Mike.
Yeah.
This is the Only Road
Podcast.
You want to say it again?
And we have our special guest here today. Jesus Christ. No, he's not here.
So Mike does something interesting before he comes over to do
a coincidence.
He listens to music.
Yeah.
He pumps himself up in his car ride over.
Yeah.
And
just in the way. The
last he's told me this before, but something interesting happened today. An hour before we were about to film, we didn't know we were both driving at the same time, and I think we had it tuned on the same station. And I told him that I was listening to a very nostalgic song.
Yeah. And then I thought in my head, well, I listened to one too.
But it's not nostalgic like you'd think.
Yeah.
It's actually kind of ridiculous. It's Heartbreaker by Mariah Carey.
Yeah. And for some reason, I just grabbed the handle of my vehicle, the volume button, and I just cranked that bitch.
Give me your love.
I don't know why I did,
love,
man.
Give me your love.
So this guy ends up saying, I was listening to some Mariah Carey Heartbreak on the way over here. And I'm like, so was I! Or not earlier driving. I like when that happens. She was a fox.
She was certainly a woman.
How do you describe it?
And we just watched the video, actually.
Yeah,
because
we were
talking about it before
we
the show.
We literally just put
we
the video
had to YouTube.
Like,
we had to YouTube the video and look for ourselves. Well, Mike said it was a great video.
Yeah.
I didn't remember it was a great video.
High
so
quality
watch.
Video. For the year it was made, it was seriously high quality. It was, though, was it not?
It was.
1999. Go watch it.
I didn't know it was 99. I thought it was like early 2000.
Yeah, you're like, no, man, it's not 99. I'm like, yeah, I'm pretty sure.
And I was adamant about it. I'm like, no.
You're like, I got to prove you wrong again.
No way this was made in the 90s.
But
I was wrong.
Lo and behold, it was.
Yeah,
now,
she
everyone
really
knows Mariah Carey was one of the greatest breasts. I mean, singers.
The breast in the business.
She is,
the best
she,
in the business.
She hits high notes perfectly. She's very good. But she was also very attractive, and a lot of men, that was for a lot of people around my age group, that was one of the first women that you kind of she was the height of her fame right as puberty was hitting, like,
yeah.
Fucking
she was the she was my one of my first crushes.
I liked her, but I didn't go hard till
woman.
After
I was in love with that woman when I was a kid.
Really?
Honestly, yeah.
She was
I
the
was
one
just head over heels, like,
yo, what'd you think of fucking Carmen Electra?
See, I
gotta hear this.
I wasn't like, she was just, she was very attractive.
Yeah.
She wasn't like, oh my God, like,
really?
I love this woman. You
see,
know, like,
you seem
I, she
like
didn't
the
have
type,
that effect.
You seem like the type that would have been, like, I just pictured you.
Why is that though? Like, Carmen Electra?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I don't know. I think she's fucking goddamn, son.
She was, yeah. She
At
was
one really, point,
yeah.
She dominated.
Yeah. So that was your thing. You liked Carmen Electra a lot?
No, that she wasn't my main.
No.
No.
Who's your main? Who's your first?
I don't know who my main
was. Remember
my
first
yeah. was probably, it might have been Jennifer Lopez, to be honest with you.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I think I got murked by Jennifer Lopez.
See,
so
I wasn't big
at an
Jennifer
early
Lopez
age,
either.
At an early age, it was about that booty.
Yes. Shakira was a big one for
Shakira
me.
Shakira was crazy,
oh,
though.
My goodness.
Shakira was
still to this day, when you see her. She had a new music video. I don't know what the song was called, but
who cares?
God damn it, she doesn't even,
who
she
cares?
Doesn't look a day over 25.
Her goddamn hips, they just don't lie.
Do not tell a lie.
They don't.
They
absolutely
can't.
Do not.
They can't.
I remember when it was like, who had the best Beyonce and
Shakira. Was that a thing?
That was a thing.
It's
they did
not
a,
hands down,
dude,
Shakira.
They did a music video together.
Yeah.
Why?
Wasn't that the music video? They both had the same like
yeah.
wig on. As, like,
same.
They looked
same
like
things.
Identical.
Yeah, they,
and then
yeah.
when you see the face, it's like, okay, that's Beyonce. That's.
I feel like Shakira's a lot more like down to earth. I'd imagine.
Think so?
Unless she does a shit ton of crystal meth, then, you know.
Well, she's Colombian. She's into the cocaine.
Oh, it'd be cocaine.
Cocagna.
Is she from?
I don't know.
Is she
like,
Colombian?
Yeah, she's actually.
You know. she had like a weird sing thing. She was doing.
I like that voice. Like, it was unique at the time. It was like kind of like it's like that Alanis Morissette like unique
no,
kind of voice,
no,
right? Like
no,
no, no. no I know
no,
what you mean.
Don't even say.
I wasn't big on her either. Like, I thought she was overrated, but...
I never
But there's her. People who will shoot me for saying that.
Yeah.
Because they're fucking diehard Alanis Morissette fans.
Yeah.
I don't get the appeal. I mean, like, she's cool, she's Canadian, but, like, other than that, it's like...
I think people just like her music, more or less.
Deep lyrics, I guess, right?
Is it deep?
Yeah.
One hand in my pocket. Hey, fame. Hated her.
Did you? Can you actually hate? You know, it was a big one for me too.
Maybe not hate.
Remember,
but
remember Jewel?
I like Jewel.
Jewel was really good.
I secretly like Jewel.
Yes.
I never told anybody about that. Wow, this is awkward.
She was gorgeous.
Isn't that a weird one? Like, you can't tell people you like her songs. We listen to it. You're six sharp as any button.
Like her. I mean, her music was like.
I liked her music.
Okay, so you were like a fan.
You thought she was hot.
I thought she was beautiful.
Okay, we're on hot. Two separate ends of the spectrum here.
Do you like her music?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Were you big on, okay,
I don't remember any
Christina
music.
Or Britney?
Secretly. Christina or Britney?
Yeah.
Fuck, man. Neither. I hate that argument.
Yeah.
If you had to, who's your favorite, who'd you pick for the
most appeal? Okay, mine's kind of weird, because back then, Britney, but not by much, and I wasn't big on Britney Spears anyways.
Yeah.
So it's like, whatever, it's by like a hair, you know?
For me, they were like a tie.
But now... Hands down, Christina. Okay.
Christina kills it. Yeah.
Have you seen her lately?
She didn't.
She looks.
She didn't
like
fall
a
into the
woman.
She
like,
didn't fall into the trap of like.
No, she looks classy now. Yeah. Like you see her in like nice dresses, and she has her like hair done. It's like
she
looks
fuck up.
Amazing now.
Crazy singer too. Surprised she didn't sing more.
She's too much for me though.
Like too high a level.
No, like it's like she tries too hard to tell everyone she's a good singer.
Did you think Fergie was attractive? What's going on here?
Oh man, that's
weird one, right?
Yes.
Weird.
Fergie was Fergie. Like that was a different like league. It was a different area of attraction there.
Did you find her attractive?
I mean, yeah, if I saw her in person, she'd be like, oh my god, this girl's really good looking. But compared to every other singer, it's like
I feel like she always had like this thing going on with her eyes where she's like squinting but she has a lot of makeup around her eyes.
Really?
She's like, hey! It was hers. My humps. Yeah, big girls don't cry. Fuck off.
That was actually a good song though.
Oh, you need to be waterboarded.
I heard it on the radio the other day, and I was like, I was actually listening to the lyrics, and I was like, wow, it's like super sad. It's like a super sad song. It's Black Eyed Peas.
Did you cry a little bit?
I got a feeling. Like, you go from like, you know, like...
Not a big fan.
Or was that an individual? That was, like, a solo thing that she did.
I got a feeling. Yeah, she had a separate career in a...
It was, like, a solo career.
In a whole... She also was a Black Eyed Peas, but they're a bunch of weird... Yo, have you ever heard that guy talk? The
yeah.
Holy... What's his name?
Will.i.am.
Will.i.am? I don't know who the fuck Apple. No, not Will.i.am. Will.i.am.
Yeah,
he's mental, dude.
I think you know what his deal is. Okay, well, okay. To anyone who doesn't know, YouTube, Will.i.am is like crazy
speeches.
Or
just
something.
Put speeches.
Yeah,
just listen to him
and,
talk.
And he rambles on. I think he tries to sound like he knows. What he's
tries
talking
to sound
about.
Like he's really smart, but
he comes off as like just like what the fuck. Hell did you just say?
Oh my god! Like, yeah, he goes to like does lectures on
like
fucking
makes no
students.
Sense.
And
it's like
shit,
Kanye,
just...
but like not on like a crazy level. You
it's
know
like
what I mean?
Kanye, like, but even dumber. Dare I say?
No, Kanye's not dumb. Like, you kind of can...
Wow.
No, look. When Kanye talks about stuff, you can get what he's saying, but he takes different approaches, so it sounds weird,
I think
right?
He's just having a hard time managing.
But with
everything.
Will.i.am, it's like, I'm just... Every time he talks, it's like, I draw blank. It's like, what?
No.
What? Like, my brain resets at the end of his fucking sentence.
I wish we had something like that. You know what?
I could find something.
No, the best is like the best.
Do you want to actually listen to something he's saying?
Like... No. You know who takes the king for most absurd... ridiculousness.
Yeah.
There's a character from the WWF. His name is Ultimate Warrior. He is the king of not making sense.
The king of steroid testosterone driven ramble.
Oh my god, he's the king.
I am the Ultimate Warrior. YouTube him. Please YouTube him.
Please.
If you make it out alive, talk about it. Send it in the comments. Quote him.
Yeah, quote him. Yeah. He's oh my god.
I eat that shit up though, man.
How much coke do you think he was on? Honestly.
Dude, he was a
so
wrestler.
Fucking
he's a
much.
Wrestler from the '80s. How is he not on coke?
He would have had to been on so much coke and steroids. And he's just losing his mind out there.
Okay,
oh
best,
god.
Best, their Ultimate Warrior promo ever.
You may have to crank them on.
And I came here for one reason. To attack and keep coming. Not fast, but just to get.
Look at that hair.
To run, holy shit. Just to sin.
He looks like some fucking Thundercat.
This guy's doing so much steroids in coke.
He's just...
Well, you're gonna get sick of it.
Holy shit.
Because this freaking nature right here...
Yeah, you're just right about that.
Jesus Christ.
And when I get big enough, brother, there ain't gonna be room for anybody else but me and all the warriors.
He puts those ropes around
the end.
He puts those fucking ropes around his chest. Holy shit. How much oil is he covered in?
You know he's got some like girl in the crack.
Yeah.
Get me ready for my promo. You can feel it, dude. You can feel it.
Oh my god, you can see when he's doing more steroids.
Loaded with the worst. In my final meeting with the gods from the heavens above.
He looks like Conan the Barbarian.
And hit me with the power of the Ultimate Warrior.
This guy's fucking retarded.
Exit stage left. Exit stage right.
Somebody forgot to oil him up on this stage.
Yeah.
Yo, he's still jacked. Look at him.
Yo.
Is this a friend?
With the command of my voice, I raised the level of the worst to one that can't be reproduced.
Dig what?
Look. Into my organs.
Into my organs.
Into my tendons. Bury your anchors into my bones. For the power of the warrior will always bring back.
Oh my god. It's fucking ridiculous. It's fucking ridiculous.
That's funny though.
You know what though?
Back then they had those characters, yeah, where they're just so over the top. Like, look.
My dad probably loved this guy.
Dude.
Straight up. As a child, he was probably like, that's the greatest, best guy ever.
I couldn't appreciate it because I was a young tyke. But yeah. In the 80s, wrestling was like
some crazy
at its
next
greatest
level
point. It was at its greatest point because you had characters like this who were over the top. Ric Flair.
Yeah.
He looked like he was going to have a heart attack every time he talked. Macho Man was on coke just like Warrior. Like, fucking, it was crazy.
Wrestling was the second or third television channel.
Yeah.
Did you know that? Ever.
Really?
Yeah.
Ever.
24 hours just did wrestling.
Like during the 70s or like...
No,
that
was
like
in the fucking 30s or 40s.
Vince McMahon Sr. when he was running the company. 50s.
Yeah. Those were the first... That was one of the first channels ever was wrestling.
Of the Macho Man.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
It's a huge part of our media. It's one of the first parts of our media ever. The history of our media. This guy's ridiculous.
This guy's hilarious.
All the way to the top, yeah. Unjustifiably in a position that I'd rather not be in.
Is he taking a shit?
Cream rise.
It looks like.
Oh yeah, Macho Madness. He has got more to offer than President Jack Tunney.
You can't emulate this. Yeah, like the characters that they write back now.
Cards stacked against the Macho Man.
Damn, they used to be so much more interesting back then.
Yeah, new wrestling sucks. Now it's just cookie cutter guys, right? Like all the same.
President of the World Wrestling Federation.
You tell me John Cena can do this?
No.
He can't cut a promo this good.
Yeah. I am the queen.
I just falling him out of nowhere. He's got a bunch of small cups. He's pulling out small
cream with a crock.
Wait a minute, though, Randy. I've got to ask you very seriously. Do you blame Mr. Jack Tunney, the distinguished president of the World Wrestling Federation, for Ricky Steamboat being the Intercontinental Champion today?
Yeah, I do. Yeah. In my moment of glory.
Oh,
yeah, I do. Yeah.
I like how he goes on con and he's like,
does he wear his glasses?
Heavyweight championship belt must fall. But the World Heavyweight Championship belt.
Here comes another cream.
Yeah.
Pull another one out. He's like David Blaine.
And there is no one that does it better than the Macho Man Randy Savage. On balance, off balance doesn't matter.
It's so ridiculous.
And I'm talking to everyone in the world.
So much cocaine.
Yeah, pretty much.
Heroin too, probably, actually. Yeah. Jesus fucking Christ, man. They're all like that, man. If you think about it, Ric Flair.
You want another one?
No more. I can't do Ric Flair. I can't do Ric Flair. I hate that fucking guy. I hate him. Yeah. He's one of the only wrestlers I hate.
Him?
Yeah, he's one of the
actually, he was great.
I always hate him.
Okay, you know, when I was
younger. He's ridic.
When I was younger.
He's ridic.
I thought he was shit, because, like, he just looked like an old man, like, ranting and shit, right? Like, every time he'd go out.
He sucked. He never beat anyone.
He didn't have a physique. He was shit. He was,
how
like,
many times
he
was
like
he
an
the champion?
Man. He looked old back in the day, and he still looks old.
How many times did he claim he was the champion?
I don't know. Some 50,000 times.
Or something. It's ridiculous. But the thing is, I never saw him beat anyone by the time I started watching wrestling.
He wouldn't beat anyone. He was always, like, he was always the guy.
He was always the guy. Oh, I'm gonna get you with an ankle lock, and you're gonna tap. Yeah. You fucking cunt. And you do that thing where Bret Hart's gonna sharpshoot your ass and kill you.
He'd do that thing where he'd get hit, and then he'd like take like a minute to fall over. Yeah. It's
like, and then just like walk, and then he'd walk, jump, like a little jump at the end, and just fall face first. So many times he would just be like talking to somebody and just fall face first.
As a kid, I thought that was ridiculous.
I loved it. But that's like, the only thing I liked about him.
But growing up after, I appreciated how funny that actually was, because like this guy took like, okay, you know how they were always,
he took a hit.
Back in the 80s and like 90s, they would always fight, prove people wrong, saying like wrestling's real. Mm-hmm. Now everyone knows it's fake. But this guy was doing shit like that while during the era when they're trying to convince people that it's real. It's like, how can you convince us that it's real when you're flopping like that?
You know what's hilarious? You know what's fucking hilarious about it?
Yeah.
That was like a, like, wrestling being fake at one point was fucking conspiracy theory. Yeah. That's hilarious. I know.
Isn't it crazy?
It's not real, bro. Yeah. Fuck off.
You know why, though? It's because back then they didn't have things like the UFC and mixed martial arts.
Well, obviously. Well, they did. Not like that, though.
I remember as a kid when the UFC actually, like...
You were like, what the fuck?
Yeah, it was like, what is this? It's like, they fight and it's for real and it's for money and, like, it's like these are professional... Blood. Yeah. It blew a lot of us away, right? Because it's like, the only thing we were used to seeing was like wrestling and boxing, right?
UFC was like the ultimate fucking hardcore.
And wrestling was...
Because we used to have ECW. Quote-unquote
real, and then boxing was a different art.
Yeah, and at one point, they had ECW.
Yeah.
And,
which is like retarded. It was like trailer park fucking...
Yeah, that shit was crazy, but it was nowhere near the level.
Like flaming tables.
It was crazy, but it was nowhere near the level of UFC. Yeah. People die in wrestling. It happens.
Not wrestling. Well, wrestling related, there are a few, like, the Owen Hart thing.
Yeah,
like,
and in the UFC it happens too, or mixed martial arts, should I say. Yeah. Rarely.
I find, for wrestling, it's they die more outside of the ring. And it's on drugs. And it's usually wrestling related.
A lot of wrestlers die from, like, drugs and shit, fucking Chris Benoit, what he did. So this guy...
You know the WWE doesn't even acknowledge him anymore.
They can't. Same with Hulk Hogan.
They, every time his name comes up, they beep it out. Like, it's just considered a censored word.
Holy shit.
Yeah. So, and also they went as far as going into their video vault.
Yeah.
And actually removing all the footage. They don't even have it stored away. They actually terminated. They destroyed it.
Can you get it on the internet?
You can get it. The only way you can watch his matches are on YouTube.
Wow.
That's it.
So this guy basically...
It's crazy, man. Like, everybody knows the Chris Paul,
I don't
right?
think that, not a lot of people really do. Not a lot of people really know about it. Not
explain it.
So basically with this guy, he was a Canadian wrestler who had been...
A very, very good wrestler. He was probably on par with Bret Hart at one point.
Yeah, he was
like a Canadian treasure. Like,
he beat a lot of people. And near the end of his career, he beat even more people. And then eventually he was a type... he became the champion. He was the champion of the world, heavyweight champion, I believe it was.
During the height of his career.
He was champion. At the very end of it. Because then he got it, and I don't know if he lost it or did he not lose it.
I don't think he had the belt. When
He won it.
He wasn't the champion when he did it, when he committed.
No, maybe he lost at that point.
Yeah.
But they blame it on the steroids.
There was a bunch of things that they said.
I really don't believe the steroids. So what this guy does is he gets, one day he loses it. He kills his wife.
It's
and his
interesting
son.
When you hear other
he kills his wife.
Talk about
he kills
what
his
happened.
Wife,
yeah.
And he waits for he goes to the park, picks up his son, brings his son home, kills his son, and then he kills himself.
Crazy
wrestling, yeah. Wrestlers. This happened to a wrestler.
They said it was a
murder suicide.
There's a former WWE wrestler who's now a doctor in it specializes in concussions.
Yeah,
went to Harvard and stuff. His name is. Fuck, what was his name?
You like think it Nick, was brain Nick, trauma? Something. Holy shit. Yeah,
no, but...
Dude, no.
They were saying that they actually, in the autopsy, they examined his brain. He had the brain, the membrane around the brain, the cushioning that actually prevents from, like, serious concussion was all gone, deteriorated.
You know
from
why?
From his brain.
Because he
had
that
the brain
move.
Of an 80-year-old man.
He had that stupid move.
That had the flying headbutt.
He would climb up to the top rope, and he would jump down... And he would flying head.
But that specifically wasn't probably what did it.
It probably
it's from
was
the years
no, no,
and
no.
years of just bumping and like
that,
he
no.
was a high intensity wrestler.
Granted,
right?
Granted, yes.
Yeah.
But they found out in recent studies that it's those huge hits that you get, they do almost as much brain damage as those small jabs that you hit that you take.
Yeah.
So even if he crushes the landing,
saying,
he crushes the landing, but he's always smacking his head on people. He's always jumping from a high height. throwing his brain down. Even though his body's absorbing a lot of the hit, his brain is still being pushed against the skull at that rate, no matter what you do.
But if you look at his style of wrestling, it was high intensity. So this guy, he wouldn't bump like normal people. Like, a normal wrestler would take a slow bump, like, off of the suplex. He'd go hard and hit hard every single time. When you're doing that night in and night out, it takes its toll.
Yeah.
Even though you're good at it, and you might not feel it now, you're going to feel it down the line, right?
So there's a good chance
So it's a combination of that, and then they said it's a combination of, you know, he could have been on steroids, would have been.
He was definitely
WWE's on steroids. Obviously, they're trying to hide it because they want a clean image for their wrestlers.
They only hid it for a little bit. I think they gave up a lot of the steroid stuff.
You know what the fucked up thing is? A year ago, before he did that, his best friend passed away, which was Eddie Guerrero.
No, didn't Eddie Guerrero die after him?
No. He died first.
Eddie Guerrero died first?
Eddie Guerrero passed away from the heart attack, and that probably
fucked him up. That was from Coke, right? That was from Coke.
Because I don't know what it was from, but they said he had an enlarged heart.
They didn't release the fucking information for, like, weeks. Nobody knew.
It was an enlarged heart, and they were attributing it to steroid use as well.
Really? Yeah, probably.
Because, okay, think about those two guys, like, Eddie and Chris were... They were very small build, like maybe 5'9", 5'10", but they were huge, and they had to compensate. They needed that extra size just to get noticed and lift like, people more attention. In the air. Yeah.
And they both did shit. Both, all their moves were throwing people around and shit, too.
Yeah.
They didn't fucking. Crazy, around. Man. You know who got out of it? Like, pretty much scot-free.
The Rock.
Yeah.
He got out scot-free. He did the smart thing, and he got into movies.
He got out without any injuries, without getting fucked up mentally, became a famous actor, dominated the world, He's the most sought-after leading man in Hollywood.
But if you hear about him, he doesn't talk bad about wrestling.
Nope.
He doesn't regret it. He loves it. He comes back every WrestleMania and he has a match or two or whatever.
As long as he doesn't bang his
head. Because I think he feels like he owes Vince McMahon for his success, right? Like, McMahon.
Then you got guys like Lesnar, too, though. Lesnar.
Yeah, Lesnar's the same deal.
Like, kind of. He does, like, real fighting, too, though.
Yeah.
But his character in the WWE or whatever it is now is basically coming to an end because Goldberg came back and just murked him like a bunch of times now.
I watched
the second one.
No, there's a Royal Rumble. It was like this past Sunday, and
how many people listen? How many people watch wrestling? If anyone sees,
I seldom
video,
watch it. Like I'll watch the big ones like WrestleMania and SummerSlam and like Survivor Series.
If anyone out there watches wrestling and is hearing this podcast, leave a comment and tell us what your opinion on wrestling is.
Favorite wrestler, whatever.
Or whatever. Or if you hate wrestling, tell us about that too.
He fucking owned him in the Royal Rumble too.
He did, yeah.
In like 2 seconds. Did you hear about that?
I heard.
Yeah, he is twice in a row now. So I think what they're doing, it's all about money, right? This is a huge deal.
You think Lesnar's going to give him next time?
No, their big match is going to come up at WrestleMania, and I think Lesnar's going to finally get one up on Goldberg, and then Goldberg's going to retire. Because he's old. He's like 50.
Yeah, right? They got to build it up.
They have to build it up.
My God.
It's all money. It's a business. Wrestling. It's a business.
I can't do wrestling, man. I'm sorry.
But I didn't expect that. I didn't expect him to get fucked over that again at Royal Rumble.
If I watch an episode of wrestling, I can tell you what's going on in all the storylines and where they all lead.
Mind you, it is very predictable, but there are some things. There are some things that shock even the smartest of people. Like
that guy, Vince McMahon, how old is he now?
He's
80, 70, something.
Gotta be out. He's up there.
He's jacked.
He was old in the 80s.
He's a jacked motherfucker, though.
He is, man.
He's like Sylvester Stallone style, but I think he's even older and more jacked.
Stallone is 60 something, and McMahon is 70. Yeah, he's an old man.
He can kick the shit out of probably me. He's a champ, man. He's a huge business.
He's wrestled in matches. He's fought Stone Cold Steve Austin. Reese's most recent one.
His trilogy with Stone Cold Steve Austin was the most interesting rivalry to ever happen in the history of the sport. Well, fake sport.
He fought Bret Hart at WrestleMania. His last match.
Who?
Vince McMahon.
When?
I don't know. It was like 2011, maybe.
Holy shit, that actually happened?
Yeah. Bret Hart came back.
Just to the WWE. Who won?
Bret, obviously. He beat him. It was like payback for the Montreal Screwjob.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
God damn it. What a fucking weird piece of entertainment.
But it was sad. It was sad. It's sad seeing Bret Hart in the ring. Because, I mean, his career was done a long time ago. I think Goldberg gave him a concussion when he was in WCW.
Would you say this is...
And then it was done after that. And then after that, he had a stroke and he wasn't the same. Like,
This is like a soap opera. It's just an exciting soap opera. I knew girls.
Yeah.
Like, I met some girls when I was younger, and, well, obviously, everyone does. But, like a group of women, and then
who were, like, huge wrestling fans?
I hung out with them a lot, and then I went over to one of the girls' house one time, and she had, like, wrestling memorabilia, and I was like...
Of who?
Of just the WWF, the WWE.
Was it The Rock or like, or just in general?
No, so this was a little after. Okay. So it's like John Cena and shit.
Oh, right. Okay.
So I'm like, you like wrestling? And she's like, yeah. And I was like, oh, okay. Like, you, that's kind of strange. She's like, and then she told me that the other girls that we knew,
yeah,
they all liked wrestling. I was like, how, you guys, and they're like, they watch it every fucking time. I was like, what the fuck is going on in the world today? But I'm thinking in my head, but they're just watching it for the fucking huge.
You think so?
Oh, for sure. For sure.
I guess, yeah, because that's their market. Their image is that, like, they want you to be attracted to
them. They want men to want to be them, and they want women to want them. Yeah. And they play it the other
way. You took that quote from...
Nope, I don't even know. I just said that now. Because it's the same with the women, too, on that they have.
There's a wrestler, I don't know if you're familiar with him. His name is Scott Hall.
Yeah, I know him.
Okay, yeah. He actually quoted, he put the business in a nutshell. Is like, the way you make money and the way you're successful, the men want to be you and the women want to be with you.
Yeah.
That's how you make money in wrestling, right?
They use the same formula with the females, too. Yeah. The female wrestlers, I mean, you don't give a shit if they're wrestling.
Exactly.
Fuck their specials.
I mean, there's some There's some weirdos that do. No. And then there's the other guys.
But then you see the women that they hire. Yeah. They literally hire the, like, you know, like the really, really attractive porn stars. They're like sex machines. They do the makeup, the tits, the boob job, all that stuff. They hire, like, the one notch down from them. Basically, or one notch over in some cases, like Trish Stratus,
the ones that like it really aggressive.
Yeah,
it's like they don't mind going in and out of the ring and just fucking each other up.
But they don't. There's so many.
You see them? They pull each other's hair. Yeah,
but there's
and, like,
so many prissy fucking wrestling chicks that are just like, I know you're getting a paycheck for just dressing like that.
Yeah,
and you are.
Yeah, I mean, back good then, paycheck. Yeah, but like now, if Trish Stratus, come on, now it's a lot better than it used to be. Like they're actually very competitive.
They can actually wrestle.
They can hang with the guys. A lot of them.
They had to because UFC's got that image now.
Well, there's Charlotte Flair.
Yeah, there's Flair's daughter. I know there's some really famous ones.
Really famous, and she's on her way to probably being the. She's probably going to become the greatest women's.
She's going to be the next Rock, basically, a female.
She's really good.
The Rock of the females.
Really good, and she's attractive. Wow. So it's like. And she has the build and everything, too. There's Bret Hart's niece.
It's different in the UFC. The chicks that are, like in the UFC...
There aren't that many attractive girls in the UFC.
People have accused me of saying... some reason people thought that I thought Ronda Rousey was super hot.
You thought that she was hot?
I didn't, but people seem to think... People I know have always been like, I thought you thought she was super hot.
I never once heard you say she was hot.
I know.
The way you would talk about Ronda Rousey is you would say... That she was, like, cool. Like, she's a cool chick. Yeah. And she could kick your ass.
She played Pokemon, that's why.
I heard about that, and I'm like, oh, okay, man. That's the kind of girl I can hang out with.
Yeah.
So that's Ronda Rousey's.
But then you got chicks like...
But she was a bitch, though. She was a bitch to a lot of girls.
Yeah, like, I know. She was
beefing ring announcers and shit, and it's like...
She's cunty,
man. We talked about this before, but, like,
But then you got chicks like Paige VanZant, where it's like...
Who's that?
She was on Dancing with the Stars.
She's
actually like, pretty
like
good.
She has
a flying head kick knockout.
Yeah.
She's a flying.
They got lucky with that.
Yeah. Well, she's got one loss now, but she had a flying head kick. You can't really.
It's like when professional sports try to push like an attractive athlete, but
they
shit.
Don't push her. They don't push like that. Though.
I feel like you know tennis did that with like Anna Kournikova. Do you remember?
Yes.
Yeah.
She had to.
Garbage.
They had to push
she
her.
She was. Probably one of the worst tennis players you could ever see, but they would push this fucking girl because she was like,
she's the only thing I know about tennis. Can you say the same thing?
The Serena and Venus.
Serena sisters. They're beasts.
Yeah, there were a few, and there's another one too. They got busted for steroids not too long ago. She was like the main.
What?
She's the face of tennis. It was what's her name? Fuck. I don't follow tennis, so I don't know.
How many people do you know from golf? Tiger Woods and.
Vijay Singh.
Who's that?
See?
No.
Like, you don't know that much about golf.
No.
So you only know Tiger Woods, right?
Yes.
See, I used to like golf a lot.
Did you?
Not a lot.
Are you a weirdo?
Back in the day. Back in the day. Well, this is
Have you ever gone golfing?
Maybe less than a handful of times. Like actual, like 18-year-old golfing, not that many times, but...
Did you have a caddy?
That's like blue blood shit. Like you're at a fucking country club smoking a cigar.
I've
like,
been to
take my club, Jethro.
I've been to a couple country clubs now.
They're nice.
They're really nice.
But I don't golf. I go more to the driving range and just crank a few balls.
Just fucking
you
smash
me one day.
Yeah, we should go smash balls together.
Smash balls together. This is fucking so much fun.
Yeah,
I get the big bucket of balls and I shot them up and I put them. Put them on the tee and
I just smash
ready,
my
and I'm ready to rip it.
I just smash that pole right in the middle of the balls.
It's fun. It's a good way to get to get good.
If you suck at it, you'll get pissed.
Oh my god, it's probably the most frustrating sport. If you're not good at golf, you will have the worst time playing that sport than any other sport.
God damn it. I wonder if I'll be good at it.
If you've never done it before, I can tell you right now, you're going to be horrible. You will not pick it up right away. No. I am telling you. This is coming from somebody who plays a lot of sports.
I'm pretty adaptive.
I know you are, but I am too. When it comes to physical stuff, like you...
But like,
golf murked me when I first played.
How are you like, with physics, though? How are you with natural physics?
Really good. I can play pool fairly decent. I can play...
You're better at pool than I am.
I can play... Anything involving physics and body movement, yeah. I get within the first 5 minutes, I'm pretty much.
But you're saying there. Not with
but
golf.
But golf is like, it's a different type of game. Like, it fucks with you mentally, too. And there's little movements that you make that you're not noticing you're making until someone corrects you. And it's like, you're doing this wrong. You're doing this wrong. You gotta move more here. It's like, and it fucks with you. It's like, wow, what the fuck? Like, you know, like, I thought I had a nice swing. It's like, I have nothing. I have to start basically from scratch and reconstruct my swing.
It's all about that follow through with golf, right? It is. That's the main thing. Same with bowling.
And the thing is, like, I'll crank out a few balls at the driving range. And I'll to this day, I've been doing it for a while. Like, every summer I'll do it. And I'm still shit at golf. I'm not good at all.
That's what another buddy of mine who goes golfing frequently, he says, like, I'm like, so you go golfing? He's like, yeah, I love it. I'm like, wow, you must really enjoy it. He's like, yeah. Are you good? No, I'm shit.
Yeah.
What do you mean, like, shit? I'm like, he's like, I'm the worst person on the course.
But he likes it. Which is weird.
He loves it.
I don't understand how... See, if I'm not having fun out there and I'm not actually somewhat competitive in it, I'm not having fun.
Yeah.
I need to be, like... Like, if I'm shooting and the ball's going in the water or fucking wherever I'm not... It's like, I'm not having fun out there. I'm the most miserable person. Unless I have alcohol in my fucking go-kart.
Do you drink when you go?
A lot of people do.
You have to.
It loosens you up, right?
You have to.
I only know a few people who are good at golf, and one of them is my uncle.
I don't know anyone who's good at golf.
He's a fucking amazing golfer, but he's been doing it for years. Really? That's the only sport he's good at, right? Like
I suck at bowling.
He puts his 100% focus into that sport.
I suck at bowling, but then it was like, I went bowling for the first time, and then it's like, once you get bowling, you got it, basically. Mm-hmm.
Bowling's not that hard to...
It's not. But
we were talking about this. Like, I can't believe that there's professional bowlers.
Oh, yeah.
Or, like, even darts. Right. Darts is another one.
You said it wasn't a sport.
Darts!
We were watching darts.
We were watching something.
I don't know why I got it.
Yeah, it's like, I have no idea what the fuck is going on right now.
The crowd's cheering, and we're just like, what?
Like, do you understand the point system?
I do understand the point system.
Somewhat, right?
Yeah.
But not totally?
No, totally.
You do?
Yeah.
Totally, 100%.
Yeah.
So, bullseye is not the best you can get.
No, the best you can get is a triple 20.
And it's, like, above the bullseye, it's the red area, and then the green above that, kind of.
It's the reason why
it's... So, it's all about combinations, then, because you get three tries, and it's, like, it's a specific combination that can get you the max amount of points.
They're trying to reduce their points from a set amount. So, you're trying to get rid of your points.
Right.
But you have to...
Right, yes.
Okay. You have to get the right amount at the end.
So, you start out with, like, 500, and then you got to get down to
You
zero,
want to go big at the beginning, and you want to taper off at the end and try to get it
to get as many shots. Pick off the little stuff.
But you got to face another guy who's doing that, too.
Yeah.
Do you like darts? I'm pretty good.
I'd rather... Like, if I'm at a bar, I'd rather just play pool. Like,
Why suck at pool?
Yeah, see, so... That's you're good at darts, so you like darts, and I like
pool. I don't really like pool. I never really got into it, ever. I've seen you play lots of times. You're pretty good.
But I'm decent. I'm not like... I can hold my own. But
you're
like,
better than a lot of people that I see play, though. Yeah. You're just being humble. I'm not that good. And I'm like, you are. You're so good. You're so good at stuff.
I'm not that good. 8-ball corner pocket. No, but I don't know. Like, darts for me, it's like... it's 100% technical.
Do you like soccer?
Like, I do.
Poor man's sport.
Is it? That's what everyone says. It's because it's worldwide.
It's
like,
just the ball.
You got those night commercials where they show the kids in Brazil playing in the street in their bare feet.
Yeah.
And then Lionel Messi just comes up and gives them a pair of like Nikes or something.
Yeah. It seems...
here you go.
It seems very intense on the higher levels.
Mm.
Except for when the people fake injuries. That's fucking the
funniest.
It's all the time, though.
Funniest.
You get like 10 fake injuries a game.
Yeah.
Don't they get like huge penalties now for doing it?
In some sports, they actually give out penalties for...
What's the one they just started doing like hard with? Was it soccer?
Basketball, I think.
Yeah, basketball. It was basketball.
Also, in hockey, they're giving out embellishment
Do people fall for hockey? Do people take falls
Not as much. Not as much. It's more of like... I don't know, hockey has like an honor system.
It's one of the only sports that has like that type of honor system, eh?
Where fighting's allowed and then they shake hands after they're done fighting. Like, have you ever seen that? They fight. Other than UFC.
They fight in hockey. They fucking fist fight.
But they don't just fight. They actually like, hey, good fight. You know, yeah. Like, that's unheard of, you know?
I have to go to the washroom.
Oh, are you serious?
I have to pee. All
right.
I have to pee. I'll be back.
Ah, I see you're back from your piss break, you turkey.
You little rascal.
Yeah, shut up, you goof. Yeah. I was thinking about that while you were taking a piss.
Let me think about another old person insult.
Old person insult.
What's another one?
It's like something an 80s dad would like.
Yeah.
It's like he's hanging out with his friends. He's like,
you know what's weird though? You know goof? The word goof, like an insult?
It's actually, I heard.
People from the 80s, it's extremely offensive. Yeah. It's really weird. I don't know if it's just Canadians or Americans too.
I think it's just Canadians because somebody told me one time that goof actually means like, isn't it like a diddler or something?
Yeah, I think it means you're calling him basically a pedophile. Yeah.
Like, but it's a bad way of saying it. Like,
yeah. It's extremely offensive, and I've seen people that are much older than me, probably like fucking almost 20 years older than me.
Like really,
I've seen them get into street fights on many different locations. The first time I ever saw it was at the drive-in.
It's basically the equivalent of like calling somebody like a fag or something.
Yeah,
right?
worse to them. So? Yeah. These guys are mouthing off to each other, and this native guy, like they're bipping off. So these guys are bipping off to each other. Yeah. And then Buddy turns around and he goes, fuck. And they're just talking shit this whole time.
Yeah.
And then this guy turns around and says, you fucking goof. And this guy, who's already been talking shit for this long, says, what the fuck did you say? Instantly, these two, you fucking heard me, you fucking goof. They just charge the big dudes, dude.
Wow.
They charge and just start beating the shit out of each other.
You know what that reminds me of?
What?
Have you ever seen the movie Semi-Pro with Will Ferrell?
Yeah, right?
Okay, do you remember a scene specifically where they're playing poker? And then one of them's like, oh, you jive turkey.
Yeah.
What'd you call me?
Yeah.
And he gets like all offended. He gets up and says, no, he didn't mean it. He called you a cunt, man.
Yeah, he called you a cunt.
He's like, no, I heard what he said. What'd you call me, man? You call me a jive turkey.
Yeah.
It's like that shit. Like, who gets like upset about this? Like, it's like with England too. Like, how they have the term wanker.
Yeah. Yeah, bloody wanker.
Yeah, like, and to me, it just sounds like it's just a funny word. It doesn't mean, like, it doesn't sound like an insult.
Yeah, it's weird. They're a weird language, though.
Yeah, it's like, oh, yeah, bloody wanker.
Listen to me, you wanker.
See, does it mean, like, you wank? Like, I don't know. Like, a wank is like a wank, right?
I guess, but the thing is about it, they're saying it like, their insults are like, wanker. Like, they're like, yeah. Ours are like, fuck. Cunt.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Four-letter words.
Damn, shit. We use, like, one syllable, motherfuck.
Motherfuck.
Like, Americans, we like our one-syllable shit. We don't give a shit for the rest of the syllables. Even in Britain, they need a few. If you say German, what do they say? Which one?
Scheiße.
Shit. Or they
that's
do,
the only one I know. It's like
their insults, like, bush enough, big enough, or whatever.
What?
It's just an insult, but it translates to English, like, monkey on my back.
What does that mean?
It's just an insult to them. You know what I mean? You're bush enough, big enough, or whatever.
You're a monkey on my back.
Yeah.
That's interesting. You know, I guess every country has its thing where they...
You know, the word schlong?
Schlong is German.
For snake.
It makes sense.
So, like, Scheiße schlong. Have you heard of a snake?
Have you seen a trouser snake before?
Well, here's my schlong. Wow, it makes so much sense now.
Yeah.
Damn Germans. Damn Germans and the great cause.
My Johnson.
Johnson.
The American term for it. Why did they call it a Johnson?
People have been named Johnson in their days.
Yeah.
Is your full name Johnson?
No. But my name's John. And you know what they called the John, the toilet?
Yeah.
Like, why? I never understood that either.
Why?
I don't know. I never. And you know what? When I was growing up, I had a friend of mine who constantly made it his mission to be like, hey, toilet.
What a
dick. But he was a friend. He was my friend, right? It was like, and I'm like, I couldn't say anything back because his name was Andrew, right? So it's like, yeah, it's like, what the fuck am I going to say? Okay, yeah, Andrew.
See, the thing I get.
Anne. hey, Anne.
Yeah, yeah, you could do that.
But it's stupid. Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
People would always call me Michelle, which is my, which Michael in French is Michelle.
Yeah.
So people are like, oh, hey, Michelle. Yeah. And then they'd be like, I know, they're thinking of like a little sticker. Yeah. Call him a girl. Yeah. But it's his real name.
That means he's a girl.
I'm like, fuck, man. But yeah. Some people get...
The kids are stupid, though.
Somebody, some people get fucking... They get the short end of the straw. Like, with names. Yeah. Like, if somebody names you Dick, like, come on.
Richard. A friend of mine, actually, his brother's name is Richard.
I like Richard, but why do people call... Why is Dick the short form for Richard?
Yeah, we would call him Dick, like, to make a point. Like, yeah. Hey, your name is Dick.
Yeah, exactly.
And we thought it was the funniest thing ever. We'd come over, hey, Dick, what's up?
It's always weird when people get, like, old person names. Like, if your name's Barbara...
Barbara.
Like old
or Barbara, yeah.
Bobby's not too bad, but...
Bob, there's Rob. I would say it as an old name.
No, Rob's not an old person name. No, not at all.
Are you talking about, like Clint? Like, it's an old...
Like, old lady name.
I only said that because of Clint Eastwood. It's like... Bartha.
That's a name.
Beulah? Marilyn's
pretty bad, too.
It's a pretty old name.
But this
Margaret
is
another old
name. Yeah, that's an old
like
person name.
It's like English name.
And that's people... Yeah. People get named that, and then, like...
That's another one. It's like... I'd say, not Dorothy. No.
No. If my parents named me one of those old fucking names, I'd have been pissed. We're just gonna call him Timothy.
Barbara isn't Barbara. I'm thinking Barbara Bush, but I'm also thinking of the first ladies because they usually have like really old timey names, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Except for Michelle Obama, that's a pretty normal. Like or Michelle
Ivanka
is a normal
Trump.
Ivanka.
Is that his daughter's wife? It's his the two Trump
daughter.
Ladies.
What's his wife's name? Melina.
Melina. That's right. Yeah.
Mortal
Melina
Kombat.
Trump. I know. That's what reminds me of too. I hate
Melina
that.
Melina and Katana in the White
if
House.
If you guys know who Ivanka Katana, yo,
Katana
Trump,
yo, Katana Trump.
If,
yeah.
If you guys ever played Mortal Kombat or didn't, there's a character from that video game named Mulana.
Mulana.
They always have
Melina.
Melina. Melina. Melina's the girl from
Disney. I'll make a man out of you.
So this chick basically, they dress her up like super scantily clad, huge tit, like over the top, right? Like porn star. But underneath her like veil, she's got like fucking giant sharp teeth. Like,
she looks like a piranha.
Yeah, she looks fucking
like
weird.
Piranha face. It's weird. It's like a, it's almost like a.
Have you ever masturbated to her?
No, man.
Me neither. Just checking.
Just checking for a friend.
I heard that's a thing.
I heard it's a thing.
Some people like that. Me, yeah. Like a little extreme. She's got two daggers ready to stab them into you, and she's just like, going to eat your face.
It's weird, though. It's like,
that'd be a weird cum shot in real life. If you're fucking her, and last thing, she takes off her veil and kills you right while you're coming. Would that be the best death or the worst death ever? Best death or worst death ever? Right there. Having sex with this fucking creature thing that you think is a normal woman.
I don't know, because...
Kills you
no,
last
kissing,
second.
Kissing is a big deal for me, so I wouldn't be able to do
anything. Let's say you... Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you would have got killed earlier.
I would have got killed
earlier. You would have got to come.
Should have just ripped my face off.
It's
like, take the veil off.
Just kiss me! Oh my god, yeah. Jaws!
Mortal Kombat. The games get violent, more violent every time.
Every time. Now the, every they got time. To the point where they're like, X-ray zoom up and show his bones breaking his skull, but he'll keep fighting.
I can never get into a Mortal Kombat game for that reason, though. It's like...
Because it's too brutal?
No, it's not even that it's too brutal. It just doesn't make any sense to me. Like, they'll be mid-move combo, and they in one cinematic, they've broken four different parts of your body, and they're still up there in a fucking stance,
crush
like pose and everything. Crush your skull. You're fine, though.
Shell spikes come like, clean through your skull, right through your
brain.
It's
almost like they do it on purpose. It's like a parody of this.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it is. It kind of is.
Like, I remember before, when,
sure
back in the day when Mortal Kombat first came out.
It was bad.
But it was kind of realistic, right? Like,
not even close to realistic, but it wasn't
bad. Well, I mean,
bad,
like,
bad.
Fatalities were fatalities,
yeah.
Right? And they ended you.
Yeah.
But then there were, like, there weren't any games that were, like, in mid, you know, fight that would fuck you up.
To that
where you
point.
Could keep going kind
of
thing.
And,
like,
and one of the Mortal Kombats for PlayStation 2. They used to be able to use weapons.
Armageddon?
Yeah, Armageddon.
Yeah, I remember.
And you would have the weapons, and you could actually stick your weapon through the person, and they would keep fighting with the weapon, and you would lose your weapon.
That game was cool because, for one thing, too, was the character creation. I liked that a lot.
Yeah, that was
really
cool.
I had a lot of fun with that.
Well, no, you're thinking of the... Yeah, that was
Armageddon. It was
Armageddon. There was one before that, though, that did that,
there
too.
There was a multiplayer...
Deadly Alliance.
I never played that one. I played...
Damn, I can't even remember that.
Shaolin Monks, was it? Mortal Kombat Shadow.
That was fucking sick. I didn't
it was
play
a co-op
it.
Game.
God damn like it. Why didn't I go back and play that game?
It was
game?
A co-op game like beat-em-up style.
Yeah, I know.
And I remember back in the day, me and my cousin
and you unlock
struggled
different characters.
So hard with this game. We got to the final boss, which was Shao Kahn, and you have to fight like...
That's right. That's
you had
the
to
only
fight...
Mortal Kombat you played, basically. Like,
me?
Really liked. Yeah.
I loved that game. It was a good game. Now, if I were to go back and play it, I'd be like, fuck this. Like,
really?
It's, yeah, like, it's...
I think I would love it.
No, it was frustrating. It was too frustrating. Like, it was a beat once only, and I made it a point.
But you
unlock
more characters the more you beat it.
You do, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But the ending boss was, like, you had to fight Shang Tsung,
yeah.
Motaro, and Shao Kahn on the same fucking health bar.
I did it. Yeah, I beat that game.
I remember we were stuck for an hour just doing, trying to do that. We said to each other, we're like, let's take a break. Pause it, leave it, come back, and let's see if we can do
I
it.
Remember
instantly we beat it when we came back.
I remember talking to you about it after I beat it. We talked. Was it? Yep. I totally remember the conversation.
I don't remember you playing it when I was
playing. I remember I was playing. I told you I beat it, and you're like, I'm beating it right now, too. And you guys beat Shao Kahn before I did, but I was by myself. And I was asking you how you did it.
You had a PS2 at that point?
Yeah. Yeah, I totally remember this.
Really?
Yeah, that was one of the last games that came out on PS2.
It was, wasn't it?
Yeah. No, it wasn't that PS2. It was PS3, dude.
You had it for PS3, then.
No, it was only on PS3.
No, I had it for PS2.
No, man, Google that shit. It was on PS3, dude.
Huh.
100% it was on PS3. Do you still have it?
No, I don't. I don't actually own it there.
I gotta find out for myself.
I'm pretty sure Shaolin Monks was...
Let's find out the hard way.
Because I remember the characters that you picked from were... it was either Liu Kang or Kung Lao. Which makes sense because the title of the game is called Shaolin Monks, and they were Shaolin Monks, right? I'm pretty sure it was a PS2.
PS3.
Get out. Get out of town, you turkey. You jive turkey.
Wait, no, you're right. Are you right? So maybe we didn't play it together.
Tell that. You have to say it into the mic that I'm right. I don't think I can hear you, man.
Hold on.
He's looking it up right now.
Give me one second, guys.
Don't deny this. First time ever that I'm going to be right about something. Yes, Mike?
Yeah. God damn it. He's right. It came out 2005. We hadn't met yet.
Yeah, 2005.
We didn't meet until 2008.
But I remember playing it after that.
I'm a fucking psychotic. I completely made up that scenario.
You made up that scenario.
It was probably with somebody else, but
it's like
I remember
a figment
that.
Of my imagination.
God damn, that was so long ago.
You have me confused with another job, probably.
Did I play it after, maybe? Yeah. No. Damn. I don't want to fucking think about this. I'm going to end up just going home and drinking cyanide and killing myself.
Playing Shaolin Monks.
Playing Shaolin Monks? Yeah. So yeah, you were saying earlier, before the show, that...
Yes. What was I saying?
You're fine.
I found a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
About
okay, go
a
on
guy
about this.
Who he builds things using primitive technology. He puts himself out in a forest, and he only uses tools that he finds. He
what?
Creates them. On
he made
spot.
All his tools.
Yeah. I'll show you a video actually.
So this guy makes all his tools from nature and builds shit with them.
He builds shit with them, like a hut, stuff like that. He only has 23 videos, because it takes him a month to film. This is, like, a long process. And then he condenses it into, like I'll pick a good one.
Reminds me of, like, Les Stroud.
Hmm?
Les Stroud, Survivor Man.
Like, here's one where he makes a forge blower. You don't even have to hear the volume. There's nothing
what
here.
The fuck? Who's this guy? Look at this skinny white kid.
I know. It's crazy. Like, he starts from scratch. Everything that you see around him... He gathered from the forest and he made it all from scratch. And the channel's called Primitive Technology.
You guys gotta go check this out.
Yeah, check this out. This guy's unreal.
Who the fuck is this guy?
He's making his shit out of clay. Like, it's nuts.
He's using tree bark to make, what is this, a fan? No.
He's making a forge blower right now.
What is that?
It's basically like a melter where you can forge, you can harden clay pots, stuff like that. Like,
really?
And he ends up using it for other stuff that he makes. So he starts, like, with the basics. Like, he makes first an axe that he needs to cut down trees.
Holy shit.
Then he shows a tutorial on how to make, like, a spear to...
Whoa! Yeah.
It's crazy, eh?
That's how he feeds his fire? What the fuck is going on
here?
He's
making clay right now. Isn't that crazy? Like, he's just digging it out of the ground, and then...
He knows what to do.
He knows exactly what to do.
This is wild, man. That's some of the wildest shit I've ever seen.
Really?
Yeah, look at him.
Yeah, look at
you guys
got to
see
precision.
This.
Look at the precision.
You
look,
have
like,
to
he
see
this.
What the fuck
like
is he making right here?
Everything. You'll see.
He's making a toilet?
No, it's not a toilet. It's a forge blower. In the end, it's just a forge. He's making an air hole for the air to escape. The fire's going to be there. That's the pit. And then he extends it, right?
Like you could make a toilet.
Yeah.
No problem.
Clay toilet.
Yeah. Toys are made out of, they're made out of ceramic. It's like kind of like the just
well,
like
porcelain.
Porcelain.
Yeah.
They have ceramic toilets.
Do they?
Yeah, for sure.
Really? That's kind of weird, isn't it?
Is it? You tell me. Holy shit. It's like... Holy shit. It accomplishes nothing, but holy shit.
Just a fancy fucking fan he made.
Where the fuck's he in the wild? Go home. Yeah. Go home, you weirdo. No, I'm kidding. This is pretty crazy shit.
It is crazy. But you wait till you see the end result. Like, that's...
It's still not done.
It. No, it's not.
Fast forward a little bit.
Yeah. I'll get...
Fast forward.
Yeah, like, see? Now he's building the fort. See, that was a piece
holy
of the forge.
Holy shit. Oh, so he builds this giant, huge clay fucking crazy thing.
Yeah.
Does he melt, like, metal and shit and fucking he forge?
He could.
Does he forge? What's he doing? Is it metal? It's
he's
metal.
Like extracting metal from...
rocks.
From rocks, yeah.
He's extracting metal from rocks? Is that how they used to do it back in the day to make swords
yeah,
and shit?
This is... Well,
are you serious?
I guess so, yeah. When he makes a tiled roof hut in this video. From nothing, dude.
Go to the
this
end.
Guy, this guy fucking...
Go to the very
he
end.
Made all of this himself. Like, all tiles, everything. From clay, gets rocks. Look at that. He's digging clay, more clay.
You know, it's funny. He probably watched a bunch of YouTube videos and then made a bunch of YouTube videos.
I doubt it. I don't know where this guy got that on. Look, he's heating up the sides so that it hardens faster.
This guy's a savage.
Yeah. All from fucking scratch.
This white guy would fuck us all up in the wild.
I feel like he'd be okay in like an apocalypse like, scenario.
I would find
like,
this guy.
This guy would know
would
how to survive
guy,
on his own.
And I would just hunt
Look
for him.
Look at that.
I'd find him and I'd just be like, yo, you build shit, I'll hunt shit.
Yeah, I think he can hunt shit too.
Probably better than I can, yeah. But that's all I can
like,
trade, man.
Yeah, he'll be the guy to say to you, like, what all can right. you offer me that I can't do?
I'll suck your dick if I can just stay at your house.
Yeah.
I'll like, suck your dick every
I
night.
I suck a mean dick, just let me come in, man.
You can
Please,
hunt.
I'll suck your dick.
You can hunt.
Yeah.
Build shit, and I'll suck your dick. And you just gotta give me food and keep me shelter. Your dick will be
I'll
sucked.
Cradle the balls.
Your dick
I'll
will be
cradle
sucked.
The balls.
One night comes, I have a cold. I can't. What do you mean you can't? I have a cold. I'm sick. You no, no, no. You have
get
to get out.
Of my
out.
House.
You have
like,
to get
oh,
out right
okay,
now.
Okay, fine, fine.
But I can't. Snot. Oh, okay. Why are we doing this to me?
No.
Are we detrimenting my character? So people believe that we're in a simulation.
There are physicists who believe that, yeah.
So if we're in a simulation
like
and
a
holographic,
simulation?
Maybe the holographic is what caused the simulation. Maybe that's the power. That's the video game system and we're the video game.
Yeah.
But it happens within a second.
It's like a series
it of... happens so fast. It happens at the speed of light. Man, life is weird.
What
life
is
so weird. Life is so weird, dude.
What is real and what isn't?
No, I know. Atoms and all that shit. How atoms, they don't... They don't. They will not turn to a solid form until they're observed.
Observed.
Yeah, that
so
one.
So everything behind my back right now.
Yeah, it's only
well,
there because I'm
you're
looking.
You're looking at it.
If I wasn't looking at it, it wouldn't look like that.
So in a sense, eyesight is the strongest thing in the universe. It can manipulate matter.
Basically. Well, I think perception.
Way.
I think perception of senses is the strongest thing in the universe.
How
really.
Is that a fucking thing?
It just That's is.
Crazy.
Adam somehow did
so
it.
What? So what those physicists are saying is that nothing in the universe exists unless we see it. Unless we
yeah.
observe it.
Yeah.
Unless there's someone there to observe it.
Yeah.
It's like if a tree in the forest falls and there's no one around to hear it, then is it really, did it really fall? Is it really there?
But there's all these animals around it that have perception, that
so
can absorb the perception.
Yeah.
So it's not just humans.
But that's just... For life in general, I mean, I it's almost
yeah.
like
yeah,
no, but
that's how life works. Things don't happen unless things are there to experience it.
Yeah, but does that make sense though? It doesn't make sense to me because
does any of this make sense? Does the fact that you even get up, is the fact that your whole body is being held together by some powerful force? You're made of atoms. You could fall. You could just come apart and turn into nothing
by touching antimatter.
Isn't it weird? Isn't it crazy?
Yeah.
Isn't it crazy? How does any of this work? How does gravity work?
What is life? What are magnets? What are magnets?
We're
how
only
magnets
alive.
Work?
We're only alive. You only get to enjoy your music and watch your favorite television shows because our planet's close that distance from the sun. Is that fucked?
It's that habitable zone where it's like the miracle spawn of life in that.
People should be
there.
So grateful that they're alive because
the
chances of you even being alive to enjoy the universe out of all the atoms that are in the universe, just the atoms that are in our planets. Like, in our solar system. Just those atoms.
You know what's crazy?
There's
though?
So many. Why are your atoms being getting the... Why are they allowed to have... Yeah. Why do they get to have to experience life, but on another planet you're not allowed?
It's interesting, because can you say that for, like, people who are having, like, a really hard life? And, like, it's like... I think life through, is... like, a personal hell, but it's, like...
That's
true. The fact
true.
That they're here living
that's
on this
true.
Earth
yes.
is, like, enough to, like...
Hey, I would say that...
This is awesome right now.
I would
no matter
say that...
what I'm no matter what, I am homeless right now. It's, like... I have nothing, but I'm here, and I'm living in the moment.
Yeah,
you know
I would
I mean?
Say
like, that's,
being
that's
alive...
Insane. That's actually crazy.
I would say being alive is the king of the crop, but
yeah.
also enjoying life is also something, like, it's very important. I think life is precious, and people don't really appreciate it. They don't appreciate other people's lives as much as they should.
Yeah, you're right.
I think in general, I think even the people who do appreciate people's lives to the fullest extent... They themselves still do not appreciate people. They don't appreciate life. Life is so crazy. It shouldn't even be happening, but it is. And you're lucky to get to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You're lucky to get a consciousness for the short amount of time
think
that you
about,
have it.
Yeah.
And people are trying to invent immortality, too, which is even crazier.
Billions and billions of stars, and, like, this planet yeah. is inhabited by... Like sure, we're the only known life form right now in the
well,
universe compared.
There's
like,
there probably is, but from what we can observe, there's not many planets that could have life.
Not many around our area, but
no.
there are billions of universes or billions
Souls.
Of galaxies,
yeah.
billions
yeah, yeah.
of galaxies out there.
For
that,
all we know, it goes on forever.
Yeah.
Well, what is forever though?
Yeah. To us, we can't even fathom forever.
That's there's, the thing too. You could say that it's a hologram, but. Maybe that initial burst of light that caused the Big Bang, maybe it's just the ignition for life.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's just the ignition for existence, but who turned the fucking key? That's the craziest part. That's the thing that blows my mind the most.
Yeah.
What was there before the Big Bang? Nobody knows. There's no way to tell. There's no way. There's no way to know what caused the Big Bang, why it was caused, how it was caused. If it were physics involved, there's something else that we don't know about that aren't physics. Like, fuck, man. Isn't that the craziest thing in the world?
It is.
How did this all start? How is life possible? How is this even fucking possible? How does any of this exist? That's when you back in the 50s or even the 40s, even the 30s, people had this idea that life was just life. You went home to your wife and children, and you went and you worked, and you went home and had a good meal. You drove your automobile. People weren't appreciating the fact that they were made up of fucking atoms and that there's space that goes on forever. Life
yeah.
shouldn't even exist.
They didn't know about that.
The complex, I know.
There were a few people who did, like Einstein.
There's a few,
like,
but most of the common person didn't.
Yeah. Well, think about even earlier than that, in the Middle Ages, when religion ruled everything. Right?
I know.
Yeah.
But it blows my mind that...
And, you know, anyone who questioned that the world was flat was sentenced... The world
death.
Was round was sentenced to
thanks,
death.
Thanks, Galileo.
Yeah. You witch.
You ruined it for us.
Like,
we could have lived on a flat earth. Things could have been easier.
Yeah.
But it's too... Oh, man. It's fucking wild. I still can't get over it. Life in general. But at the same time, life is also horrible. Life can produce circumstances that...
Life is life. It's,
yeah, I know. But you're right. There are some lives where you got to think like... it's like a life of like, say like an Ethiopian child that never eats. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or like someone who's brought into like sex slavery and their entire life is violent sex slavery.
Yeah.
Slaves. Oh, slaves who got treated like shit. Is that a life you'd want to live? Mm-hmm. Do they have moments of bliss?
But it's like, it's almost to the point where like...
do they have moments of bliss that are worth it?
Oh yeah.
Do
I would assume,
so?
I think so. Because it's like... To me it's like the way I see it is... if that's all you know... And then you can find moments of happiness no
yes.
matter what your situation is. Because if you're a bird, if you're a bird that is born without the ability to fly, you can't miss it. You don't know what it's like.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But you're living your life. I mean, it's all you
no,
know,
but
right?
What if
it's somebody born without the ability to walk.
Yeah.
You're not going to know what it's like, so you don't exactly miss
but
it.
I'm sure,
right?
but
you
I'm sure you'd be
like.
Pissed to not have it.
Do you think so, though?
No, I'm thinking, you know, no, it's not like that. Like, yeah, of course you would.
I don't know about that, though. Like, you'd have to ask somebody who's born blind or, you know, born without the ability to talk. Like, they would find other ways to communicate. It's one thing to lose that ability, but it's another thing to, like, not have it to begin with, you know? Like,
so you think
like
it's,
having that lifestyle.
So
like,
you think it's worse...
It's worse to go from riches to rags
so
than
you,
it is...
You believe it's worse to... go blind than it is to be born without vision.
Yes, a lot worse.
I know.
Because you know what it's like to have that moment of like happiness, and it's just taken away, you know. Like, a lot of people take it for granted, right?
That's a crazy scenario. Imagine being born blind.
Being born because you don't know. You can't. You've never seen the world. You grow up your whole life,
and it's like everyone else can see. We can all see.
There's a crazy a video I saw where a girl. I don't think everyone's probably seen this, but there was a female born. I think she was born deaf.
No. Are you talking about the one who was born blind?
No, she wasn't born blind. She's born deaf. Couldn't hear. She had lost the ability to hear at a very young age, so she didn't miss it, right?
Yeah.
She had some work done, and they increased, like, frequency on her eardrum, like, with, like, some kind of, like, machine.
Yeah, I've heard these, yeah.
And she heard things for the first time. She broke down in tears.
Yeah.
Because she'd never experienced that before, right?
That's fucking wild.
Yeah, it's crazy. But before that, she was living a happy life. Like, she was fine, right?
There's a
like,
girl, and they featured it in a movie recently, but there's a woman in real life that, in her, like, early 20s or late 20s, she developed split personality disorder. And she had like 7 personalities or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
She was blind her whole life. 3 of her personalities could see. Didn't even know she was blind.
3 of her personalities could see?
Could see.
And she was actually blind?
She's blind from birth.
I don't understand that. Like she would actually see things and she could tell you that they're there.
3 of her personalities had no clue about her other personalities being blind.
So this was a strong rooted like psychological thing then.
Well, that's the thing.
Like convincing her that she was blind?
That's what you gotta ask yourself.
You can't.
That's what you have to ask yourself. Is the cure for being blind, even though they can give people, they can see now, is the cure for being blind thought? How powerful is the human mind?
Very powerful, but I don't think it would be that.
It is.
To convince you that you're blind?
Dude, she's not convinced. She's just not blind.
She just can't see because of her mind.
No, I don't know. I think, what if that's the case for everybody except for people who've been chemically burned and shit?
Yeah.
What if, well, maybe not all people, what if a certain percentage of people that are blind, it's really just a thought process?
Like placebo.
Not placebo, just how their brain chemistry works.
That could be a possibility.
Could have a lot to do with...
So you're saying she had a split personality disorder?
Yes, that she developed later.
Two of her personalities could actually...
I believe 3 of her personalities could see.
Could actually see things.
Yeah.
And... they did tests where they would test her. Yeah. Like, she would know where things were. Like,
she could see. Yeah. She could see. She didn't, like, she could see to the point where she didn't know she was even blind. Like, the other personalities weren't blind.
That's crazy.
That's so weird. But that makes me think about split personality disorder as well, though.
Yeah.
That sounds pretty crazy, too.
Yeah. That's, I mean, at that point, like I said, like, it's probably, like, deep-rooted psychological problem, right?
Is it a problem?
It's a problem because, like, she can see with 3 of those 4 personalities.
No, but I mean a split personality problem.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But you don't think so?
I think, yes, it's for us, common people, but I think having a split personality
is
very weird.
No, it's something wrong there because I think really the reason you have
those...
It's
something wrong, yes.
The reason you have those split personalities is because it's a defense.
Yeah,
you have different types of personalities that... you bring out at certain times to defend from certain other things, right? To save you from certain scenarios, right?
That's fucking crazy.
It's like when somebody doesn't enjoy talking about something that happened to them in the past, they're going to bring out their tough side, and it's like, yo, I'm a wall right now, you know?
Yeah.
You can't break this.
But they can't control it.
But then, yeah, exactly. But that's like a level that every human has, right? But then you have split personality disorder where it's like, you can't control that shit, you know? It happens like... it's like a trigger.
Yeah.
Kind of crazy. It's like insecurity like times 10.
I wonder how many times someone's killed somebody and said it was their split personality.
And I'm sure they would write off that they would throw it away and say it's an insanity. It's a case of insanity, right? Like they are insane,
I would say.
Like it's you're clinically like medically mentally not stable, so like
I think it would probably only be real if you could never come back from it. Because I feel like something that's like when the brain breaks, you can't really fix it.
You don't think so?
Not in that case.
And from split personality, you don't think it could be
cured? No, not that. I think we will. I think human advancements.
I in think brains, so. If there's a no. If there's a traumatic event that caused it, you could always go back to it. It would be difficult. Because you'd have to, it's a lot of barriers you have to break down, right? You could go back to it and reconstruct that person and make them, like, you can help them be, you could help them be put back together again.
What do you think
they do that with a lot of, like, addicts and people with like psychological problems.
I know that, you know, but like, what do you think of dementia and Alzheimer's then?
That's a different level.
That's just actually the brain's.
That's actually the brain just shutting down because of old age, right? Like it's.
It scares the shit out of me.
It does.
I think that would be.
Does it have a history in your family or at all?
No, not mine.
That's scary. That's the worst thing to happen to anybody. Is when you have a loved one that suffers through Alzheimer's, and they just slowly start forgetting like who they are, who you are. You know, like they've never met you before.
I've seen it happen with people with brain cancer as well.
Yeah.
They start forgetting.
What's it called? Yeah, terminal brain cancer, right?
It'll happen there too. But it's weird though. Also, if you never spoke to somebody who has dementia, dementia and Alzheimer's.
Have you known anyone with dementia?
Yeah, I've known a few people. Well, I've known people who've known people, and it's weird. Like, I would see this guy interact with his grandmother, but he would interact with her like. He would kind of try not to, like, set her, like, he noticed that every time that he would remind her, like, who he was, she would just be like, oh, yeah, like, it's like she's faking it, you know what I mean? Yeah,
and it's to the point they realize that person's feelings.
Yeah.
It's like if I were to come to you and I didn't know you, and then you said, hey, man, like, why are you treating me like this, you know? It's like, well, I'm going to try to treat you better because I know it's hurting you, you know?
I think it's scary for them.
It is terrifying for them.
I think when they're like, wait, you're my son, like, or like my grandson, I'm supposed to know you. What's wrong with me? You know what I mean?
There's a video I saw where a guy actually documented the moment that his mother.
Oh yeah, I heard about that.
Forgot who he was, and it was like it was heart wrenching.
I didn't watch it. I saw it.
I watched it. You know?
I skipped over it.
You know what the fucked up thing is? I watched it early in the morning when I was starting my day.
Oh,
like right before I was ready to go to work, and dude, I'm in the car, fucking, like, I was so sad.
It hit you in the feels.
It got me right in the feels, because, like, this guy, they ended their day, he went and took her to get a haircut and everything, they got ice cream, they went to Timmy's, had a coffee.
He was filming it.
It was just, like,
not thinking.
It was, like, his documentation of her adventure, or, like, her experience through... Or the ordeal, like dealing with dementia and Alzheimer's, right?
Wow.
And then he ended up asking her a bunch of questions, like, do you remember your husband? And he said it by name, and she didn't know. She forgot. And then he asked her, do you remember your son? Which was him.
Yeah.
And he mentioned himself by name, and then she had no idea who he was talking about.
Holy shit.
And then that was the moment you saw it in his eyes. They started watering up and everything. It was like
whoa. Oh my God.
Felt so bad for the guy. Like, that was the moment he knew. And then after when he dropped her off for the day, like at the retirement home or whatever.
Yeah.
He went in his car and just bawled like a baby. He lost it, and he said to himself, like, that's probably the worst day of my life. Wow. And it feels like she just died. Like, you know.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Damn it. Why'd you have to bring this podcast to a super sad moment?
I never want to go through anything like that.
Jesus Christ.
Because if you think about the person you care about the most, and they just forget everything that you are. And
I don't want to think about that.
I know. The brain is a very, very scary, scary instrument.
It's horrifyingly scary. But it's also amazing.
It is. Very powerful.
I think it's time to wrap up, guys.
Wrap up.
I got work in the morning. Do you?
Yeah, of course.
What time are you getting up?
I get up at 6.
Oh, and I hear people say, like, when people start waking up early, like, man, I choose to wake up early. I get up at 7 every morning now. I'm like, you're waking up early at 7.
Who chooses to get up early?
You're awake, but still, you're getting up at 7? That's not early.
That is early for me. If it's a weekend where I can sleep in, like, I'll sleep in.
No, I know, I know, but it's weird when people are like, and I'm like, dude, I used to get up at 5. At one point, I used to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning.
That was before you drove, though, right?
Like, it was before I was driving, and I had the bus everywhere.
Isn't it a world of a difference?
It's the best thing.
Yeah. It makes you so lazy, though.
It totally does.
You start to see the pounds back on.
I noticed I stopped doing more, like, it makes you lazy in general.
So lazy, because, like, it's like, typically you could walk down the street. It's like a minute walk, but it's like, I'm just going to hop in my car, it'll take 5 seconds.
I'm not lazy about that kind of stuff. What I'm lazy about is, like, not even lazy, but it's like, if I want to go somewhere that would normally take me, like, an hour and a half to get there, I'm going to drive there in 5 minutes. Yeah.
And you don't have to plan your day around it. Yeah. You just get in your car and just hop in. It's like, whereas before, like, I was driving when I was a fucking kid, I was like, you know, I have to plan around it. It's like, okay, well, I'm going to go here. It's going to take me an hour to walk there. Then I can do this while I'm there. And then it's like, where it's like, you don't have to think about it. Yeah, you don't have to think. You did not want to go back in. You don't have to think about that anymore, right? It's like, you drive, it's like, oh, I forgot something. Gotta go back.
When I was young, I used to love walking, though.
I do. I still do. I mean, when I have somebody to walk with, it's cool.
Yeah, then you can do it.
It's engaging, right? Yeah. It's not, like, boring. It's stimulating.
Yeah, when you're walking, I can't walk to destination. I know people that fucking won't walk for fucking 5 minutes though, and then down the street.
I don't get that. It's like, well, I mean, like, by yourself it kind of sucks. But even then, like, I'd have music with me as well.
Yeah, right? Music. Like, I forget what it's
like
to walk.
Like a theme song every time I'm walking down the street. Yeah. I'm playing my own theme song.
Alright guys, we're getting out of here.
Yeah, alright. Have a good one. We'll see you next time. Like, subscribe, rate, all that jazz. Fucking leave us comments.
Leave a comment. Who's your favorite Power Ranger?
Who's your favorite wrestler? Who's your favorite pro wrestler of all time?
Who's your favorite Power Ranger?
Power Rangers, yeah.
And who would you kill given the chance?
And what's the secret to life?
Yeah, I'm sorry I went on that whole tangent there. I just didn't really.
It's okay to go deep once in a while.
I took some Kratom earlier.
Alright, see you later, guys.
Yeah.
Bye.